Hey, a pleasant good day, everyone. This is Sports Fan News. I'm Joe Borig, and this is going to be a quick Philadelphia Flyer weekly roundup where, first of all, we're going to get to Wade Allison is the real deal. He's looked great in five games as far, able to pot one goal, but really generating a lot of chances there for his teammate via passing himself, getting open in front of the net, and drawing rebounds from the goaltender to be able to get to his teammates or be able to draw rebounds, generate chances for himself. So he's been very active out there. Also been pretty good on the other end of the puck as well. So he's definitely the real deal. Looks great on both ends of the ice. Has a lethal wrist shot he hasn't even been able to use entirely yet. But once he starts drawing people open, or once he gets open and he just gets to fire that wrist shot rather, or he can create the shot himself, then he's going to have that lethal wrist shot, and you're going to be able to see that from him, because that's also what he has. But he's a great net front presence, great at passing it from behind the net as well, and can just kind of do it all. Great energy that got brought into this team, so he's definitely the real deal. He was very fun to watch covering the fans for Flyers Nitty Gritty. Please subscribe to them over there as well, and subscribe here, please. Trying to get the numbers up, trying to get to 140 by the end of the month, only at 127 right now, so please subscribe. It would be greatly appreciated, and tell your friends as well. But Allison's definitely the real deal. He just knows how to do it. He, of course, should and will, I would presume, be back on the ice tonight as the Flyers take on the fan, or take on the Phantoms, take on the Devils. I have the Phantoms on my mind because that's a video I'm doing later, but take on the Devil tonight after the Lehigh Valley Phantoms beat the Binghamton Devils, the Devils minor league affiliate, in a game last night. So hopefully the Flyers can follow suit and do that, but we'll get into that in our weekly preview. They unfortunately had, when you're going bad, it all goes bad. Brian Moose Elliott played a very solid game against the Islanders. Honestly, he saved the Flyers' bacon a couple times in that game. They played a better game. It got 0-0 to OT, and then you get an unfortunate bounce off of Sanheim's stick on the pass in front of the net from Letty trying to get it to Eberle. That ended up being Nick Letty's goal because it never got to Jordan Eberle. Then we had bad bounces in that game. Then we had, unfortunately, James Van Riemsdyk have a bounce that goes in, which I would count as a bad bounce too, because you never want to see a guy score. Yes, it ended up going in the net, but you never want to see a guy score off of his face like that and get almost injured from that. But it ended up being a fortunate bounce after a bad bounce that almost injured JVR, who then comes back in the game, scores again, and then Voracek on the pass where it looked like on the play, the 2-on-1 where it looked like he was going to pass, where JJ even called the pass almost to G and then even apologized for it afterward. He's able to shoot it and make that shot, which he has a good shot. He just needs to use it more, and he used it there. It was great to see. And he was able to make it. And then Artemi Panarin scored later in that to bring it to 3-2. But Brian Moose Elliott played a fantastic game that night. They had 35 shots on goal. Flyers only had one more because they had one more in the third period. He played a great game that night. And Igor Shesterkin also did for the Rangers. But then the next game, the final game of this weekly roundup, I'm not sure who AV was kind of saying when he said two scoring chances, basically two goals again, who he was fully blaming there, because Chris Kreider on the power play is wide open in front of the net. Maybe Moose would get across for that. He's also a bigger goaltender, but I don't even think he would have saved that or hard. I mean, you're leaving Chris Kreider, who's one, a Flyers killer, but two, a power play killer, wide open in front of the net. And that's just the way it is. Also, shout out to Chris Kreider. He does a lot of good for the New York Rangers through their network, through MSG, and he really does a lot for children that are sick. That was on MSG for people that want to check that out. On their YouTube, he's one of the greatest guys in the league. Excuse me, but he was able to get open in front of the net. Then Oscar Lindblom was able to score the Flyers' lone goal on a backhand assisted by Voracek and Couturier, but that's the only thing they were able to get. They let Pavel Vinevich literally just skate. That looked like a play when you're just playing pickup hockey at the roller rink where you're just able to skate in front of the net because nobody's really great at defense that you're playing with. Nobody picked him up there. So, yes, it might have been two grade-A scoring chances, two goals against, but that's because nobody can play defense. I'm not sure who AV was blaming with that quote. If it was Lyon, I would say those games. Is Alex Lyon going to be the most sexy, greatest NHL goaltender? No, but he's serviceable when you play in front of him. We saw him beat Boston before. We saw him beat the Avalanche before. And look at a guy like Alex Stalock, if he can be just like that, he's picked it up for the Wild before. He's now on the Edmonton Oilers, but as a third goaltender, but when he was on the Wild, he had that great stretch run with them because they played around him. It wasn't just because of him, it was because they also played well around him. This Flyers team played pitiful around their goaltender in that game and left people wide open. Then Lafreniere and Hytl were able to score, who were both also pretty open. So, a terrible defense in that game. That was the bad game of the week where, yes, they had more shots, but they still did not play good. Left guy's fine. It's two scoring chances if they've even put it like that, but guess what? They're wide the hell open on both of them. One on the power play and one the guy just skated in front of the net. So that's entirely on your defense. Terrible defense in that second New York Rangers game in the back-to-back. First one, very good game. JVR was, of course, the star of the week because he's able to score off of his feet. Two bad bounces this week. The one for Nick Leddy, the start of the week, but then one that almost injured JVR, but then it became fortunate because it went in, but still will count that as a bad bounce because it almost injured one of our star players. And then he's able to come back in and score. And then Jake Voracek scores again. When it looks like he's going to pass and he's able to bury it in. He has to take advantage of that more. People anticipate him passing. Take advantage of that more and keep doing that even more. But good job by him there. And then terrible showing in the final game by our defense. Letting Bunevich just skate in front. And nobody guarding Chris Kreider on the power play. Just letting him be wide open in front of the net. That's inexcusable. But this has been the Philadelphia Flyers weekly roundup. They could have went 2-for-3 this week if they could beat the Islanders. But they win one game. Due to the game in New York that JVR really stepped up. And then they did terrible in the other showing. And then, unfortunately, a bad bounce off a Sanheim stick on the Nick Leddy play. Hopefully, this week will be a better week. They got three games against the Devils. Even the Flyers team that's been struggling should be able to take 2 out of 3 against the Devils. But I'll talk about that in my weekly preview coming out shortly. I hope you all enjoyed this video of the weekly roundup where we had some bad bounces this week. Nice two games from Moose. And also just... Wade Allison, I mean, it's pretty obvious. Wade Allison is the real deal, excuse me. But also in that Rangers game, we lost. A secondary thing I should add is Jackson Cates did have a very solid debut for the Flyers. So there's at least some solace, I guess, to go off of when it comes to them struggling mightily in that game. At least Cates had a good debut and was actually 62% in almost 12 minutes of play in the faceoff dot. That's really good for a youngster. Tanner was good as a center when he first came up. There's been some comparisons to Scott Walden for Jackson Cates. If he can do that, that would be great to see. But that's the end of this weekly roundup. Hope you all enjoyed. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And have a great and safe day, everybody. And enjoy all the hockey action. Peace out.